Hey guys, here we are back on Wind Chaser. I just pulled over one of my trucks to go empty it out. Have our low beams and high beams on here. Put a new indoor light. Low and high beams, just a little bit better lighting in the dark here with the real light mod. See how this handles with the four-wheel drive. Was handling just a little funny, like it was front heavy on the front wheels there under a full load. So just went ahead and did a little bit of adjusting. Another truck. Work on the combine as well. Added butter.
Yeah.
pipe light here. So I added an indoor light. Added the pipe light so I can see what I'm actually doing. So we're getting a pretty decent amount of corn out of this field. We have two trucks already working on our third truck. Overall, the corn crop's doing really well. Like all these lights going on right now. Percent more to go in the tank. Probably buzz on over here to our green card. fits over. No problem. This has a little indoor light. Just eating corn. Thank you. are back in the luxury combine. Tell you what, that Lexion with the bin extension and 16-row corn header, the thing just eats corn. I think the new bank mod, it allows you to lease the bank mod that allows you to lease land. It's like version 2.3 now. It's a great idea. However, every time I buy land and try to sell it, or lease land and unlease it, it like makes all of my crops disappear and it changes all the terrain and stuff, and it's just kind of annoying. So I sent the authors of that mod some screenshots to better explain what I'm experiencing, and I think other people are experiencing it as well. Otherwise, can't really use the feature of leasing fields right now, but I wish I could, because it, you know, I lowered the price just because, you know, everything is set up to use on, like, the in-game maps, or everything is, you know, like, 10 times a realistic value. So, I put down, you know, otherwise it was charging me, you know, like, $90,000 a day to rent the field. So I messed around with the interest rates, and it's around $2,000 a day for the same field, so a little bit more realistic. So since our grow seasons are like 20 days or something like that, maybe 25, something around there, so you can pretty much get two seasons out of a lease, and you know, it cost you, or it would cost, you know, 40 some odd thousand plus or minus a season to rent that land. You know, that's a pretty decent size chunk of land that would cost whatever it is. It was field 44 we're leasing now. To buy it, $750,000. Otherwise, that costs us $22,000 to lease it. And it's right around like $2,000 a day or something. So that's very, it's very, you know, it's better to lease the land and, you know, buy the equipment. You know, you can rent everything, but, you know, if you were to keep buying equipment or renting equipment, it's expensive. And it's annoying to always go back to the dealer, drive to the dealer and stuff. So if you're looking to expand, it's nice to actually lease the land, because, you know, that field 44 that we leased, we probably put, I don't know, we probably burnt up right around 45,000 or so in land to rent it. Then we burnt up probably, well, I don't know, maybe 20 to 30,000 in fuel and seed and nutrients. So you're probably looking at 60,000 or 70,000 into that field. And then we got, what do we get out of it? Thousand liters of canola out of it, and at a great demand, you're probably looking at $1.20 a bushel, $1.20, yeah. So, you know, for every truckload of 54,000, we're probably looking at 64 to 70,000 in income, you know, during a great demand. So, you know, we put in 60,000-70,000, and we're gonna make 250,000+260,000, so maybe 270, whatever the math comes out to. So it's probably you put in 70,000, you get 270,000 out of it, so 200,000 profit, which is not bad for farming that field. It's not even a bad investment. It's less trucking, less people required to farm. It's the same nutrients and herbicide as corn and soybeans, so it's a pretty decent crop to complement the rest. I mean, our corn crop is yielding pretty good. It's not ideal. Ideal is around 250 bushel an acre. This is probably around 220 bushel of corn, maybe. Maybe more. I think it was around 270 bushel of corn. That's ideal. So this is probably around 230 bushel of corn that we're playing with now. So, because we're 30. I think it was every 10% away, it's a 5% reduction. So that's like a 15%. We're probably like 20% away. We're 80% of ideal. I'm gonna guess we're probably around 210, 220 bushel. We can usually pull corn out of the field pretty quick. When more than one person's on, we have a second combine rented, not, you know, something like this, but a modern class 9, class 10 combine. Thing is, the bins, they fill quick. And so you always need to have, if you're running a combine, you always need a cart driver. If you're running two, you definitely need a cart driver. And you definitely need a trucker too, because that cart will get full pretty quick. But if you're running 2 12s, it's not nearly as bad as running 2 16s. You get a bigger cart just because that cart cannot fill a truck all the way, where a 1500 bushel cart can fill an entire truck in one unload, so it's a more efficient operation to get the trucks out and give a space for the cart to unload. So we're at pretty much completely full with this one. I think we're pretty much full with our cart. That one really should be hooked up to tillage and be doing tillage, but you know, we only have so many people running equipment. There goes the train by with the lights. At least my interior light's working. Here comes the train with the lights on. Thank you. is so much bigger. One little patch left